নমস্কাৰ, স্বাগতম জনাইছোঁ এতিয়া বাতৰিলৈ। ষ্টুডিঅ'ত মই প্ৰাঞ্চল প্ৰতিম হাজৰিকা। দেশৰ পাঁচখন ৰাজ্যৰ বিধানসভা নিৰ্বাচনৰ দিন ঘোষণা কৰিছে মুখ্য নিৰ্বাচন আয়ুক্তই। আমি পোনপটে এখন প্ৰচাৰত আপোনালোকক নিৰ্বাচন আয়োগৰ সংবাদ মেলৰ মাজলৈ লৈ গৈছোঁ।
Or probable candidates or any other group related to election shall be allowed till 15th January. Commission shall subsequently review the situation, considering the situation of the pandemic, and issue further instructions accordingly. So up to 15th of January, there is absolutely moratorium of physical rally and physical road shows. Between 8 p.m. and 8 a.m., no rallies and public meetings, similar like a campaign curfew. That on any campaign day, that will continue. No nukkar sabhas will be allowed on public roads, roundabouts, or public streets or corners. Fifth, no victory procession after the counting shall be allowed, and not more than 2 persons shall be allowed to accompany the winning candidate or his or her authorized representative to receive the certificate of election from returning officers. So we are reducing the physical contact, physical availability, and we are saying that more and more virtual and virtual rallies, virtual campaign should be done. However, physical rallies during the campaign period, if after considering the situation, which is very dynamic, and when permitted after the decision of the commission, shall be conducted subject to adherence to COVID-19 guidelines. The maximum limit of persons allowed for indoor and outdoor rally meeting shall be as per existing directions of SDMAs. For these meetings, political parties shall distribute masks and sanitizers to persons attending and maintain COVID protocol at entry and exit point. Further rallies and meetings shall be allowed only in earmarked places and with prior permission of district administration. Door-to-door campaign, a maximum of 5 persons, including candidates, excluding security personnel, if any, shall be allowed to do door-to-door campaign. Each political party candidate shall have to furnish an undertaking in the application form under Suvidha that it shall abide by all the extant instructions, guidelines in this regard. So an undertaking will also be taken whenever any rally will be allowed. Later on, when we review the situation after 15th or something like that, only then, again, also these undertakings, COVID guidelines have to be strictly followed with each and every person who is involved in the campaign.
We'll take up your questions thereafter.
Non-compliance of instruction, anybody violating the instructions on COVID measures will be liable to proceed against as per the provisions of the Disaster Management Act, besides legal action under IPC and other legal provisions as applicable. And the prime responsibility will be resting with the CS and DO as mandated under the DM Act. And our guidelines specifically reiterate this legal position, and the guidelines will be given to each and every one of you. It is reiterated that in case of breach and disregard to the above guidelines, the Commission will not hesitate in cancelling the rallies or not allowing any further rallies by that party. So the COVID protocol is absolutely quite restrictive and quite strong, basically, that way, so that we can see that no physical rally will be done up to 15th of January. Media, I would like to come to the media now. Media has always been a friend of ECI and has played a very significant and positive role in elections. And this time also, we implore them to help us reach out to all stakeholders regarding safety norms and higher voter participation. It is you only who communicate our message to the public. It is you only who motivates them to cast a vote. It is through you only that we send our messages to them. So you are our friend, and you are the person who can help us in achieving our goals. Social media has also become an important component of life, and Commission has been engaging with social media platforms since 2019, and a voluntary code of ethics had come into play, which will also be applicable. Commission has been engaging and requesting all political parties and candidates to ensure that their supporters do not indulge in hate speeches and fake news. A strict watch on social media posts is being kept to ensure election atmosphere is not vitiated in any manner. any person, organization indulging in such malicious activity will face harsh consequences. Now I will come to the schedule of elections, I think which you are waiting, and that is something which is very important and a very most important thing. During this time, we have also seen and perused that how the elections were conducted in 2017, how they were conducted in 2012. In 2012, this was done, all the five states were done in 9 phases. In 2017, this was done in 8 phases. And now we are reducing it by one more phase, and all elections of 5 states will be conducted in 7 phases. I will give you the, I will read it and I will give you.
Total 7.
All the 5 states combined together will be completed in 7 phases. I'll give you a detailed chart, then you can understand more. Should I start? Because for this you are waiting. That will not be complete without, you know, starting this thing. And the first date of the issue of notification will be 14th January 2022, and which will start from Uttar Pradesh. This will be the first phase of Uttar Pradesh. The issue of notification is 14th January. Last date of nominations, 21st January. Scrutiny of nominations, 24th January. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 27th January. And date of poll, 10th February 2022. This is the first phase. Now let us come to the second phase, which is a very important phase. In second phase, we will be covering 4 states. Uttar Pradesh, second phase. Punjab, in one phase. Uttarakhand in one phase, Goa in one phase. So Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand and Goa. In second phase, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Goa will be over. And here the issue of notification will be 21st January. Last date of nominations, 28th January. Scrutiny of nominations, 29th January. And last date of withdrawal of candidature, 31st January. At date of poll, 14th February, that is Monday. Third phase, only Uttar Pradesh. That is issue of notification, 25th January. Last date of nominations, 1st February. Scrutiny of nominations, 2nd February. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 4th February. And date of poll, 20th February.
আৰু ইয়াত নিৰ্বাচন আয়োগৰ সংবাদবিলাকৰ পোনপটীয়া সম্প্ৰচাৰ উত্তৰ প্ৰদেশ গোৱা মণিপুৰ পঞ্জাৱ আৰু উত্তৰাখণ্ডৰ নিৰ্বাচনৰ দিন ঘোষণা কৰা হৈছে 10 ফেব্ৰুৱাৰীৰ পৰা নিৰ্বাচন অনুষ্ঠিত হ'ব আৰু সবিশেষ তথ্য পৰৱৰ্তী বাতৰিত আমি সম্প্ৰচাৰ কৰিম ইয়াৰ লগে লগে সময় হৈছে এতিয়া বাতৰি পাবি লোৱাৰ নমস্কাৰ
এতিয়া বিষয় জানে স্ট্ৰং মানে মাই ফান ষ্টীল নিৰ্মাণৰ মানদণ্ড